स्टूडेंट टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस अंडर मुस्लिम लॉ। नेचर ऑफ द हेरिटेबल प्रॉपर्टी फर्स्ट जनरल प्रिंसिपल एसोसिएटेड विद मुस्लिम लॉ। द मीनिंग ऑफ हेरिटेबल प्रॉपर्टी इज दैट प्रॉपर्टी विच इज अवेलेबल फॉर एन इनहेरिटेंस टू लीगल हेयर आफ्टर ए मुस्लिम डाइज हिज प्रॉपर्टीज आर यूज टू पेइंग द फ्यूनरल एक्सपेंसेस डेब्ट्स एंड द बिल्स। आफ्टर द पेमेंट ऑफ दीज एक्सपेंसेस द रिमेनिंग प्रॉपर्टी इज रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज हेरिटेबल प्रॉपर्टी। For the purpose of inheritance, the Muslim law of inheritance does not make any distinction between the movable and immovable property or corporeal and incorporeal property. Any property which is in ownership of the deceased at the time of his death would be considered as heritable property. However, under the Shia law, a childless widow is entitled to 1/4 share of the movable property owned by the deceased at the time of his death. Joint on or ancestral property. The Muslim law of inheritance does not recognize the concept of a joint family or of copastary property. In case the Muslim dies, his property devolve on his heirs in a definite share of which the heirs become the absolute owner. Similarly, when such legal heirs die, the properties owned by him will devolve to his legal heirs and the same process continue also. There is no distinction between the self-acquired property and the ancestral property. No bright line under the Muslim inheritance law. Islamic law follows the principle of nemo est heiris viventis, that is, nobody can become an heir to a living person. This means under Muslim law, the legal right to inheritance of property arises only upon the death of the deceased and not upon the birth of the child. Another point to note is that an heir can only gain a share in the property of the deceased if the heir outlives the deceased. However, if the heir apparent dies before the deceased, then he or she will gain no right to inheritance, and thereby their family members cannot take up their share in place of them. The doctrine of representation is a well recognized doctrine under the Roman, English and Hindu law of inheritance. According to the doctrine of representation, the son of the predeceased son represents his father for the purpose of inheritance. The Muslim law of inheritance does not recognize the doctrine of representation because under Muslim law, the nearer excludes the remoter. In simple words, if there are two heirs who claim the inheritance for a common ancestor, the heir who is nearer to the deceased will exclude the remoter. Thank you so much.